Good day, brothers and sisters. We offer this Mass for our deliverance from the pandemic of COVID-19. The frontliners who unselfishly offer their services in these difficult times. For those affected with the virus and other diseases in those who have died. For proper guidance and enlightenment for civil and church leaders. For those who send their private intentions. For the benefactors and friends of the Basilica, and for our personal intentions. Let us now dispose ourselves for the celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass by praying the act of foundation for holiness. Eternal Father, I offer you the sacrifice wherein your dear Son Jesus offered himself upon the cross. To adore you and render to you that honor which is your due, acknowledging the supreme dominion of all things and your absolute dependence on you. For you are our first beginning and our last end. To give you thanks for God has benefits received, to appease your justice for all to anger by so many sins, and to offer you worthy satisfaction for the sin. And finally, to implore your grace and mercy for myself, from those who are in tribulation and distress, to all poor sinners, for the whole world, for the blessed souls, for the Lord. Amen.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people, and bestow your peace on our hearts. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, God is not unjust so as to overlook your work and the love you have demonstrated for his name by having served and continuing to serve the Holy Ones. We earnestly desire to demonstrate the same eagerness for the fulfillment of hope unto the end, so that you may not become sluggish, but imitators of those who, through faith and patience, are inheriting the promises. When God made the promise to Abraham, since he had no one greater, by whom to serve, he swore by himself and said, I will indeed bless you and multiply you. And so, after patiently waiting, Abraham obtained the promise. Now, men swear by someone greater than themselves, for then an oath serves as a guarantee and puts an end to all argument. So when God wanted to build the heirs of his promise and give a clearer demonstration of the immutability of his purpose, he intervened with an oath, so that by two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie, we who have taken refuge might be strongly encouraged. So hold fast, so the hope that lies before us. This will help as an anchor of the soul, sure and pure, which reaches into the interior behind the veil, where Jesus has entered on our behalf as for one, becoming high priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart, in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has borne renown for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord. He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has sent deliverance to his people. He has ratified his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. His praise endures forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever. Please stand.
As Jesus was passing through a field of grain on the Sabbath, his disciples began to make a path while picking the heads of grain. At this, the Pharisees said to him, "Look, why are they doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" He said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he was in need and he and his companions were hungry? How he went into the house of God when Abiathar was high priest and ate the bread of offering that only the priests could lawfully eat and shared it with his companions?" Then he said to them, "The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. That is why the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. It is a very clear principle that the Lord taught his disciples that human traditions are not over what is divine. In other words, human laws can never be over divine laws. Ang batas ng Diyos ay lagi nasa ibaba. Ang batas ng Diyos ang basihan ng lahat ng mga batas. And the law of charity always is above any other law. And that is why on the Gospel today, when Jesus was passing through a field of corn, even though it was on a Sabbath, and we know that during the Sabbath, the Jewish people were restricted in their movements, and they are not supposed to do movements that are unnecessary. Even just plucking the ears of corn is considered a violation of the Sabbath. And Jesus rightfully taught that the Sabbath was made for man, in the sense that man has priority over any other human traditions. In other words, the dignity of the human person is above any other thing else in this world. And that is why charity always is supreme. Kung ano yung ikabubuti ng katawan ng tao, kung ano ang ikabubuti ng kaluluwa ng tao, kung ano ang ikabubuti ng buong pagkatao, ito ang ating pinoprotektahan, ito ang ating dinidefend. My dear brothers and sisters, the Church has always the law of charity as supreme. And this is why the Church will always cater to the needs of the faithful, even in difficult times. Pero, para sa ating din, mga nandito na nagsisimba, at sa panahon ng pandemic, kinakailangan sabihin natin yung mga kalituntunin, yung mga batas, gaya ng mga batas nito, gaya ng pagsusuot ng face mask, ng face shield, ng pagkakaroon ng contact tracing. Ito lahat ng mga bagay nito ay magsisilbi para rin sa ikabubuti ng tao. And it is for our own good, it is for the common good, and it is very good for all of us, so that we will be spared from the pandemic of COVID-19. So, kagawa muna ng paraan love God and you love your neighbor. So let us be obedient to what our government officials, especially the IATF, will provide us as guidelines. Let us be respectful and at the same time always thinking what is best for ourselves and what is best for our brothers and sisters. This is what it means for us to be always charitable to others. When we wear our mask, when we wear our face shield, that means we care for one another.
Please stand.
Let us pray to God, our Father, who has called all his sons and daughters to become free in his Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Participate worthily in this Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
The Lord of the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the Word to whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as without end, with one voice we acclaim. Who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we be merited to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
and my soul shall lead you.
the body of Christ.
Amen.
Let us bring down the spirit of our communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I look for you in my soul. Since in that hour seeing you sacramentally, come please spiritually into my heart. As though you have already bound, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, create me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Permit me not to be separated from you. From the wicked foe, defend me. At the hour of my death, hold me and be in God to you, that which has sins. Embrace you forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the Spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Listen.
God, our loving Father, you sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news of salvation to all, to sinners, the poor, the oppressed, the sick, the abandoned and neglected. He gave his life on the cross for us and rose again to new life, to redeem us and reconcile us to you. You sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles to continue the work of your Son and to lead all to salvation. We thank you, Father, for bringing us from darkness into light through your loving plan 500 years ago. Missionaries came to our land to proclaim the gospel of Jesus, your Son, to our ancestors, that made us your people and the church. The gift of faith has accompanied us through through both darkness and light, defeats and victories of our history as your people. Our faith has become for us true light that shines in the darkness. Renew in us the grace of your Spirit that impels us to be witnesses of Jesus your Son to a world broken by greed, violence, injustice, sickness, and suffering. May our faith bring us to unity as your children, to care for and love one another. May the Holy Spirit empower us to be proclaimers of the good news to our brothers and sisters in Asia and to all nations. Give us a sincere desire to help others to come to faith in the Lord Jesus, to share in your joy and love. May the Blessed Mother, the star of evangelization, accompany us and pray for us as we live and share our faith with others. May our strong love and devotion to her, as our Ahana Iman, form us to be true disciples and witnesses of Jesus to all, always ready to be sent and to be obedient to whatever Jesus asks of us. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Pia,
pray for us. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. And a special grace to thy God's love through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lady of Pia, pray for us. And the Father,